One thing that has to be understood when we look at the hadith is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Utitu jawami al-kalam." I was given the comprehensive words. In other words, he will say a very short statement, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like ad-dinu nasiha, and with that one simple statement made up of two words only, books can be written. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke, although he spoke in clear Arabic tongue, which could be understood at many levels. And this is why the simplest of the Sahaba understood clearly what the Prophet was saying, and the most sophisticated of the Sahaba understood clearly what the Prophet was saying, and their understandings were not the same. The understanding of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu is not the understanding of the other Sahaba, and that's confirmed in more than one hadith. It does not negate that one is right and the other is wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by the nature and the depth of his words, there are multiple meanings. There are many, many ways of understanding the same thing, but they must be within the rightly guided boundaries of the people who know. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَسَأَلُوا أَهْلَ ذِكْرٍ كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people who know if you don't know. The people of dhikr, the people of tadabbur, the people of tafakkur. So, having said that, I just want to make it clear that what we want to do, all of us, is to reflect deeply. Not to be people that simplistically take things without reflecting on them. They take them at face value. Now the other, I think that Allahu A'lam, we can extrapolate and take an ishara from this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. I think one of the possible meanings of this hadith is that if you look at the word amma, amma is actually a very positive word. In fact, we call the female is called ammatullah, like the male is called abdullah. If the amma is a servile creature, then the rabba is the one who is the master. Now, the idea of the mistress giving birth to the master, if you look at the Arabic words for hadara, for darul Islam, for the thaqafa, for ma'rifa, most of these words you will find are feminine in nature. And the word actually for civilization, which is ummah or hadara, is a feminine word. Now one of the things that has happened in recent time, and I would say modern history, because modern history in a sense begins with the Renaissance, is that the Muslim ummah gave birth to Europe, quite literally. In other words, Europe was a completely abject, servile, ignorant society that had no knowledge whatsoever, and through the knowledge that was transmitted by the Muslims literally gave birth to a civilization that becomes the master of the Muslims. In other words, it's the Muslims who empowered Europeans and secondarily Americans to literally become the masters of the Islamic Ummah. And we're living in an age where the Ummah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the civilization that was in servitude to Allah, is now the slave of the arrogant mutakabbira, this arrogant and proudful European civilization, which has no submission to the authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and is in fact in absolute and utter rebellion to the traditions of the prophets. And extraordinarily enough, they have divorced themselves entirely from their own Christian tradition. And they mock their own prophets on their television programs and their comedians who make fun. الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا آيَةِ وَرُسُلِ هُزُؤًا. They take my signs and my messengers, not just the messenger of Allah, but Isa alayhi salam and Musa alayhi salam, where literally Islam gave birth to a civilization that would take over and supersede the Islamic civilization and treat it like some abject servant that it orders about. And now in every single Muslim country, you see these servants, these pathetic, barbaric people who are ruling the masses of Muslims, who are in abject servitude to their masters in the Pentagon and in Langley and in Washington DC and in London and in Paris and in Tokyo. This is the pathetic condition of the Ummah. So we literally see where this Ummah has now become an Ummah. And the Ummah is this Rabbah, which is Western civilization, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.